And now, that's late. Beautiful.
Little Miss Rebecca, for my dog. Come on.
Just come with me to the JB Radio Network. Whoa.
Extreme weather events related to climate change are going to play an increasing role in the future of our world. How can we better protect coastal communities exposed to these weather events? I've asked atmospheric scientist and Columbia University professor Adam Sobel to join me here in New Orleans, a city recently devastated by Hurricane Katrina. Using his unique expertise, we can better understand how to protect people at risk in an uncertain extreme weather future.
The climate is changing. We know that the Earth is warming due to human emissions of greenhouse gases. We're certain that the sea level is rising, and the risk of flooding disasters to coastal communities like New Orleans is increasing.
In my work, we try to understand hurricanes and what the risk is of disasters like Katrina happening.
We expect that as the climate warms, hurricanes should get more powerful, and the risk of getting a big one, like a Katrina, may well increase. A hurricane can be destructive due to rain, due to wind, or due to storm surge. What we've seen in many places is that storm surge is what kills the most people.
So how can we better prepare ourselves and societies to face these risks in a changing climate?
Short-term preparation is tremendously important and brings great benefits, but it's not enough. To really protect people, we need to also plan in the long term for the risks that we know are there. The surge barrier is a 2-mile-long, nearly 30-foot-high wall that's designed to keep the water out of the city of New Orleans if another hurricane comes. This is part of a long-term planning effort to be prepared for future storms.
A structure like this protects people from natural disasters, so there's a tremendous benefit to having it here. At the same time, there are costs to having it here, such as the cost of building it and the impact on the ecosystem. Our science is about assessing what those risks are so that we can weigh the costs and the benefits correctly when we have to make decisions about whether to build a structure like this.
The research project that I'm doing with AXA is about patterns of extreme events and how they're related to climate. I'm trying to understand those patterns and not just what the changes are likely to be in one place, but how changes in extreme event risk are related across different regions of the Earth. In the long term, we need to plan better against the risks that we know we face in a changing climate. That can include engineering solutions, infrastructure changes, and awareness of what the science tells us. Although we can't reduce our emissions of greenhouse gases enough to make the problem go away, we can reduce the burden that we're giving to future generations.
As an atmospheric scientist, I study the climate and the weather, and I do it because it's fascinating, but also because this is the atmosphere that all of us live in, and so what it does matters to everybody on the planet.